Chapter 14, Reducing It to the Ridiculous. One spot at a time, spray, drop the paper towel, then use your toe to mop. Cousin Donna. Nurturing the dream is like planting a seed and helping it grow. It takes weeks to grow and months to mature, and in the intervening time, you think about it, visit it, check on it, water it, and most of all wonder what will happen. Nurturing is keeping it alive and respecting your purpose. Nurturing isn't about timing. It is what you do in the midst of timing, good or bad. It is what keeps us going when times get tough, wondering what is next. Maybe you love what you do and you're happy with it. Does it make life a little easier doing something you love? Is it what you want to do forever? Or are you thinking about making a change? Nurturing the dream is giving it a place to grow and sprout wings. I moved into a brand new mobile home. The kitchen and dining room were huge. The linoleum was white. Cousin Donna came for a visit. Knowing me like she did, she grabbed the glass cleaner, a paper towel, and said, "This is what you have to do. Every time you spill or see a spill, just grab the spray, squirt it, drop the paper towel on it, and then use your toe to move it around, and voila, it's clean. Don't wait until you have time to mop the whole floor, because, well, it won't happen." Thus, toe mopping was born. Reduce it to the ridiculous. Small baby steps to help us get through. Looking at the big picture can be overwhelming in any scenario, but when you break it down into steps, the process seems more manageable. Life can get overwhelming, and it is easy to get lost in all the to-do and lose sight of the want-to. Taking steps towards your dream keeps it real, just baby steps. Take the big picture of your dream, which may seem overwhelming and, well, impossible, and break it into small, doable parts. Ask yourself, what is one step, one thing I can do today toward my dream? Set aside a certain amount of time each day or each week for dream maintenance. For a long time, my fear kept me thinking about it, talking about it, and that was great, exciting, and fun. I loved thinking about it. Taking action, well, that was another thing. When I knew there was a job opening and I wanted to take in a resume or CD, I would choke. I was scared to death and a little embarrassed. What if they laughed me out of town? I would ask my friends to hold me accountable. Did you call today? I would say no, but I promise I'll do it tomorrow. Sometimes it took everything I had to muster the courage to take a step. Remember, I got my share of no's, and guess what? It didn't kill me. I took on the saying, fake it till you make it. I had to believe and go on pure faith at times. Yes, I got discouraged. Yes, I cried. Yes, I, well, cursed. It was all part of the journey and adventure. I had stories to tell friends about who I met and what I saw. This was scary, exciting. I kept thinking, what if I don't try? I'll never know if I could have made it. I didn't think I could live with not trying. I didn't want my tombstone to read, she was just too scared. Or worse, what if? I wanted to be an example, to pave the way. I wanted to live in you can do it. Sometimes people are raised being told they can do anything. I think that's a disservice because we all can't do everything. There are things we are good at, though, and there are things we are passionate about. Along with all the wonderful stories of people who have made it against all odds, there are stories of people who fell into a great opportunity. There are people who want to do or be something, and they're no good at it. My coach wanted to play pro football, but when he was getting ready for college, he got an injury, and that put him out of the game. He loved football, but he also loved speaking. He is now speaking and doing his best to raise money to buy an NFL team. My partner in coaching tells a story about a woman who is a terrible singer. Her mother led her to believe she's a wonderful singer. You can imagine how that turned out. We've all seen American Idol, and the singers hope beyond hope that they make it. And when they don't, they're angry and crushed. For some, it opens doors. For others, it was just another letdown. I think that is the danger in hoping for one thing and only one thing. If it doesn't come true, we're devastated. When we wonder and accept the adventure and journey, it can lead us somewhere we never expected and to something we might like even better. It can show us the way to jobs, careers we didn't know existed. The dream is the driving force. What we do with it and our attitude about following it will guide our steps toward fulfilling it. Some people have more than one thing they love, more than one goal. Maybe one will be a hobby. Here's the thing that drives me. When we are doing what we love, we're content in our lives. We love better, we give better, and we're living our purpose. And that gives us a sense of fulfillment. I want to give my time, money, and resources. It's important to me, but if I'm miserable working at a job I hate, even if I make a lot of money, I won't be all that great to be around. When we love what we do, we love our lives. We have found something we love in spite of a difficult life, children with disorders, or caring for an elderly parent. The dream, what we love, will fuel us. It fills our cup, and then we're able to give to and love others. We've all been around people who hate their jobs and hate their life, and they seem to, well, hate everybody. Finding your purpose, discovering your dream, and taking steps toward living it in some way, it's the greatest gift you can give this world. It's a gift to you. Your joy in it is a gift to others, and the world was waiting for you because it knew all along you were meant for this. Some people don't believe they deserve anything good. They think it's selfish to live what you love. Some people even think we're supposed to be miserable, that our purpose here is just to suffer. And at times I've almost been convinced myself that we're meant to be miserable. But here is the question I ask. How miserable do we have to be to make God happy? Not everyone is going to think about, let alone pursue his or her dream. That's sad. I want to encourage everyone I encountered to live their dream. Find what you love and give enthusiastically. Many people give because they should. Some give begrudgingly. In the Bible, it says God loves a cheerful giver, and this is so deep. What does it take for us to be cheerful givers? Confidence that we have enough to share, faith that there will be enough for us, belief that what we are giving will make a difference, no matter how big or small. A heart of cheerful giving comes from a loving heart. When I'm living my dream, feeling a sense of worth, like what I do matters, then I love better. And I give better. In fact, I give cheerfully. Many kids go to college to be what their parents want them to be. People take certain jobs because they should, and people give up on dreams all the time, and it breaks my heart. I hear people shatter the dreams of others with their negativity. It hurts my soul. We all have different things we love. At my workshops, when we all write or say 20 things we love, no two lists are ever the same. We all have our unique desires and dreams. They are ours, even if other people call them silly or call us dreamers. Take the job you should, but make plans to live your dream. Life happens. Single parenting happens. Dreams get hijacked. Don't let them die. Keep them alive. 1 month, 1 year, 10 years. It's never too late to live what you love, be it a job or a hobby. Find something that feeds your soul. It isn't selfish. It is self-full. It gives you what you need so you can give others what they need. It's life. What is something that feels overwhelming to you? What is one small step you can take? Now another. Before you know it, you're well underway and it's no longer daunting. Now there are some projects that are so overwhelming you can't possibly take time to work on them because you have so much going on. In fact, you don't even want to do it because once you start it, you feel an obligation to finish. Sometimes a small step will be giving the project to someone who in fact has the time and wants to do it. Throw it away, give it away, take it away. Sweet relief. What is one project you can check? Sometimes we just fill our time with things that are meaningless and not even something we want to do, and yet they have a hold on us. Sometimes projects are nothing more than a diversion to keep us from what we love, our dreams and desires. We can just think about our dreams, but surely we don't have any time to work towards them because of all our unfinished projects. Sometimes we're just trying to stay busy. But when we free up our time and let go of some projects, we create space for new things, for what we really love. We can just think about our dreams, but surely we don't have any time to work towards them because of all our unfinished projects. Check some, I dare you. Another aspect to taking steps is the way to our dream can be lonely. There are people who want us to get there faster, slower, or not at all. And some people get jealous or think you can't do what you love and still keep them as friends. And some people, well, they just don't seem to understand. Can you face the loneliness? Realize it may be for a time. I want connection and community, and when I feel like I'm going it alone, it's really hard. It feels like I'm doing something wrong. Leadership can be lonely when you are taking the steps to your dream. It is a place of leadership. Don't take it as a sign you're on the wrong path. Remember Frodo in The Lord of the Rings? When he set out to destroy the ring, all the elf and dwarf and other leaders joined with him. It was so beautiful, but then some of them came up with ring envy and tried to get the ring away from Frodo. So he went off alone to accomplish his mission and ended up in a castle tied to a slab of rocks. His good friend Sam showed up and carried him out. He thought he had to go it alone and was willing to do so for the mission, but discovered he had a friend that could help. Loneliness is part of the journey. Try to embrace it and make the most of it, rather than indulge it with sadness and pity. Toe mopping, reducing it to the ridiculous, and baby steps are the keywords to help you move toward what you love. The big picture can be too much and seem too impossible, but step by step, you'll make it. Just wondering. Do you fall into any of the categories that deny you the ability to live your dream? Selfish, suffering, not worthy? If so, which one? Tell me about it. How did this attitude come about? What can you do or say to give yourself permission to change that? What is your dream? Okay, well, what's an idea you have thrown around and wished could happen? What does reducing it to the ridiculous look like for you? What would one step toward the dream be? Is it scary? Good. Ask a friend to hold you accountable or hire a life coach. Have you experienced loneliness on your journey? What was it like? Did it make you want to stop and settle?